Color 10 is your local election headquarters. Greene County Clerk Shane Scholler says if you haven't already sent in your ballot by mail yet, don't. Color 10's Bailey Stroll is up first here at 5 with more on other ways you can still cast your ballot on or before Election Day. What'd you find out?
That's right, David. In order to vote, you'll need to bring your mail-in ballot to the polls, or if you think you can qualify to vote absentee, bring it to the Election Center. There, you can surrender your ballot, and poll workers can then issue a new one to fill out on site. Thousands of mail-in and absentee ballots have already been received by the clerk's office, and today, election workers started processing them. For anyone that's already voted by mail in Greene County, your ballot has made its way here, the University Plaza Convention Center in Springfield.
Today, we're alphabetizing all of the absentee mail-in ballots that have been received back, and then that allows us to go through and audit them to make sure that the notary seal and signature is there, that the voter has signed it properly.
In Missouri, mail-in ballots are able to be processed 5 days before the election. Greene County Clerk Shane Scholler says tomorrow they'll start opening envelopes and sorting them into batches, which will then be taken back to the Election Center to be counted on Election Day.
So everything you see here is going to be transported back and forth. We won't leave any voter's envelope here. It's going to be taken back to a safe and secure room that is underneath security and camera both.
Then on Election Day, workers will start tallying mail-in ballots around 8 a.m.
And then those batches will be run through a high-speed counter. Okay, so hopefully, if everything goes well, no equipment issues or anything, those will be some of the first results that we post that night.
That's because all ballots casted in person on Election Day cannot be counted until the last voters leave the polls. Scanned ballots are then tallied on a memory stick inside the voting machine. That memory stick is then...
It's brought back to the Election Center, and those are uploaded. And then from that upload, that's what we'll report, the uncertified results.
Now, when you combine all the mail-in, absentee, and votes casted in person, Scholler says we can expect a higher-than-usual voter turnout, somewhere between 75% and 80% here in Greene County.